As a result of studying this section, you will learn rules in general, requirements concerning the steering gear. SOLAS 2004, Chapter 5, Regulation 25. This is the administrative hierarchy that has been established by the United Nations in order to develop an international standard of rules covering maritime matters. United Nations. United Nations Headquarters in New York. IMO. International Maritime Organization. This committee consists of representatives from all the member countries. IMO made the SOLAS rules. SOLAS. Safety of Lives at Sea. A comprehensive set of rules made by IMO to ensure safety at sea. Class rules. These are rules set by the class companies, such as DNV, De Norske Veritas, LRS, Lloyd's Register of Shipping, ABS, American Bureau of Shipping, GL, Germanischer Lloyd, and others. For regular ships, the rudder must be able to turn a minimum of 35 degrees to each side. To meet the rules concerning rudder angle velocity, the rudder must be able to turn from 35 degrees to 30 degrees on the other side in maximum 28 seconds. This is called the minimum angle velocity. The steering gear must be big enough to turn the rudder to 35 degrees port and starboard at full speed. This torque is achieved at a certain oil pressure working on the vanes of the rotor. The safety valve is set at a corresponding oil pressure, minimum 25% above this. When the safety valves open, the oil is allowed to bypass the vanes. In addition, the steering gear is to be pressure tested with a much higher pressure. This is done by the manufacturer before delivery. The hydraulic system should be designed so that single failure doesn't put the steering gear out of function. The procedure diagram for emergency steering should be easily seen in the wheelhouse and steering gear compartment. The emergency steering is done by the use of the non-follow-up push buttons on the starter cabinet or directly on the directional valves on the steering gear. The system shall be looked after by monitoring important functions specified in the rules, such as oil levels and power supply. The monitoring is done by placing sensors in these important areas. These sensors, either one by one or in combination, activate different alarms. The operator of the steering gear must have the necessary competence. The steering gear's vital functions are to be regularly checked by the crew, and the crew are to be drilled in emergency procedures. Chapter 5, Regulation 25. Operation of steering gear. In areas where navigation demands special caution, ships shall have more than one steering gear power unit in operation, when such units are capable of simultaneous operation. Chapter 5, Regulation 26. Steering gear, testing and drills. 1. Within 12 hours before departure, the ship's steering gear shall be checked and tested by the ship's crew. The test procedure shall include, where applicable, the operation of the following. Point 1. The main steering gear. Point 2. The auxiliary steering gear. Point 3. The remote steering gear control systems. Point 4. The steering positions located on the navigation bridge. Point 5. The emergency power supply. Point 6. The rudder angle indicators in relation to the actual position of the rudder. Point 7. The remote steering gear control system power failure alarms. Point 8. The steering gear power unit failure alarms. And Point 9. Automatic isolating arrangements and other automatic equipment.